Welcome, thank you very much to the participants and organizers. I'm Deniz Chips. I work as a volunteer at Digital Cultural Heritage Network in Turkey. In this presentation, we would like to talk to you about our project, Bulgic Knowledge Repository for Cultural Heritage Post-Earthquake Disaster in Southeast Turkey, supported by the Wikipedia Foundation, which we realized as a Digital Cultural Heritage Network in Turkey. We prepared this presentation with several teammates. I'm making this presentation today on behalf of our teammates. In this presentation, I will first tell you about our team and why we chose to use Wikipedia. I will give information about the earthquake disaster in Turkey on February 6, 2023. Then I will talk about our project and our activities. The network aims to bring together people working on digital cultural heritage in Turkey. It's aimed to create a research infrastructure and bring together a group of experts for those who want to access the right information, especially students in Turkey on digital cultural heritage. In addition to this, it's designed to create Turkish content for this field, to identify the legislation, standards, guidelines, and principles that are lacking in the fields, and to establish working groups relating to this. All work in the network is carried out on voluntary, non-profit basis. Within the network, individuals with different areas of expertise and interest share ideas in the areas they want to work in. As a community, we believe that knowledge should be shared openly and free of charge and made accessible to everyone. Every knowledge produced is universal and ever-changing, self-living. At the same time, there is more than one person who produces and changes knowledge. Wikipedia is the encyclopedia that makes knowledge easily accessible, modifiable, shareable, and sustainable by everyone. As a community, we first try to create and develop our network's Wikipedia webpage. At the same time, we were trained by Wikimedia Community User Group Turkey to use Wikipedia. On February 2023, two major earthquakes occurred with Kahramanmaraş as the epicenter. The Turkish government and the World Health Organization have declared a state of emergency for the earthquake zone. Syria was affected by the earthquake along with 11 provinces of Turkey. In the aftermath of the earthquake, there was huge loss of life and property. People lost loved ones and the cities they were grew up. The damage and destruction caused by earthquake is still ongoing. The earthquake affects the western Mediterranean and southeast Anatolia region of Turkey, which has a rich historical and cultural diversity. The earthquake also damaged cultural, historical, and archaeological values in this rich geography. In order for earthquake-affected individuals to continue their social life, their culture, traditions, and history had to be kept alive. We believed that, especially with photographs, these values could be brought together with society and shared over the internet. When we start to examine the tangible cultural and historical assets affected by the earthquake, we couldn't find sufficient researchers. The data on the internet was quite insufficient and messy. The government of Turkey had only shared numerical data. Since the data is quite unorganized and inadequate, we decided that we should create the data. We concluded that by organizing citizen science, we could collect data and share it with the community. Wikipedia was the most suitable place for the implement our project. In order to bring together this data, we applied for rapid funds offered by the Wikimedia Foundation. When we applied for the project, we decided to two face-to-face and two online editors and various individual discussions. After our project was approved, we shared with those concerned at the Wikimedia, Wikipedia, Wikidata and Wikiglam project seminar. We invited social media channels. First of all, we created a list of libraries, museums, and archaeological sites in the earthquake zone. Through this process, we realized that there was no list of cultural institutions that we called LAM. We observed that even the list of institutions affiliated to the Ministry of Culture was incomplete. The data form provided on municipal institutions was also quite scattered. We shared this data between the participants on the editathons and provided data input to Wikipedia. After creating this list, we checked whether the cultural sites had Wikipedia page and realized that most of them did not. After creating the final list of participants in the event planning, an info pack was sent to the participants by email. The info pack included information on how to open their Wikipedia accounts and videos. We have organized our face-to-face event on February in Istanbul. At the event, we first talk about our community and the purpose of our project. Orçun Madran and İlkayot from the Creative Commons Türkiye team participated in our event and talked about copyright and licensing. Orkut Yılmaz from Yertizanlar Association gave information about OpenCityMaps public mapping activities. And Wikimedia user group Türkiye introduced Wikipedia tools and explained how to enter data by showing examples from various projects. Our second face-to-face event was hosted by TET University in Ankara. As in the Istanbul event, we shared our community and the purpose of our project with the participants. Orçun Madran from the Creative Commons Türkiye team talked about the copyright and open licensing. And again, Wikimedia user group team answered the question of the participants with the informative presentation. Existing cultural memory institutions in Turkey have data on cultural assets in the earthquake zone. For this reason, within the scope of the project, we want to come together with experts working in relevant institutions. First, we made a list of institutions in Turkey, searched their email addresses, and sent invitations to our online meeting. We introduced our project to expertise, for participants from mayors, provinces, and institutions. We explained how they could share existing data using Wikipedia. We talk about our work we can do in cooperation, and many institutions connected us again after the event. On April 2024, we held the online editathon with participants. We received positive feedback from those who were unable to attend face-to-face via social media. We shared information with participants from different provinces of Turkey. As a community, we think that cultural heritage should be shared and accessible, and we are working accordingly. In this process, we consider it would be more important to raise awareness among university students about the relevant fields. For this reason, we participate the Professor Dr. Nevzat Özal's Information Management in Museums lecture with the senior students of Ankara University Department of Information and Record Management and talk about our project. 29 students supported our project by working online from April to June. We can say that Wikipedia data entry work we carry out with Ankara University over a period of about 3 months give more productive results than the daily editathon, because in one day we could only explain our work and Wikipedia to the participants. There was not enough time for the participants to enter data. We start our project in December 2023 and completed in July 2024, when we examine the total numerical data in this process on the data. we believe that we have taken a step toward bringing together the cultural assets damaged in the earthquake zone. We have guided the participants and many people. In this process, it took us quite a while to create a materialist due to the scattered data and limited access. Participants experienced difficulties during data entry on Wikipedia. We realized that participants needed training on digital information literacy and access information. In the future, we plan to organize various meetings to raise public awareness. We hope that our study will guide the projects to be realized in the future. We would like to thank all our supporters who have been with us in this process. And thank you for the listening. And now we're done. What about our
thank you very much. We created our community group page in the Wikigram page, so to explain our community and what are we doing. And our first aim was to create a references or the publication list for the all digital cultural heritage related in Turkish. And we thought that first we have to use Zotero, or we have to upload all the Turkish material references into the, our web page. So we started to upload into web page, but it was not sustainable. And then we created a Zotero group for our network, and then everybody tried to apply, enter all the references in Turkish into Zotero. And then thanks to the tools that is working with Zotero and Wikipedia, it was easier than adding all the references into this publication page. So we created these videos and projects related to digital cultural heritage, so the old people who has interest in digital cultural heritage in Turkey, in Turkish, they can come and contribute to this page. And after that, earthquake happened, and then we created this project together. And then thanks to Wikimedia Foundation, they gave us grant to try these devices, digitatons, and the education activities. So we, after that, we created this Wikipedia Glam page for the for our Rapid Fund project. And also, it was a three steps for the project. One is to, like Dennis mentioned, that we have to create a list for the Wikidata items and for Wikipedia pages. So we were working on this Google Doc in order to track the articles for Wikipedia and also for the Wikidata items. And the second step was to gather all the information related to earthquake and disasters. So did we publish anything about the disasters for the cultural heritage protection? So we found that there are several publications published by UNESCO and Ministry of Culture and Tourism, several academicians in Turkish, and then there are more templates. What could you do for the disaster times, etc. So we gather all these publications and the projects together and I put it in this publications page for the earthquake project. So and after also that was some initiatives before the earthquake for all kinds of disasters. And then also after that there was some reports, publications after the Kahramanmaraş earthquake. So we also gathered this information and the reports, publications, and putting under this. So the next step will be to tag and then make a category for this to before and after earthquake reports, publications, etc. So that people also, this includes the news about the earthquake. So if an editor during the editorial needs to check the web page or the publication or the news about the Kahramanmaraş earthquake zone, so they shouldn't get more search, so they can come and use these references to write an article much more easily. So that was the one step after the creating list and etc. And while we are trying editing Wikipedia articles and Wikidata articles during our editathons, we experienced that we were trying to explain the Wikidata property and all these new token data things. It was a bit difficult for everyone to understand the links, how it comes, how it goes, etc. But we made some trials. So then we try to add the significant event for each item, like 2023 Turkey Syria earthquakes. So when we have the our list with the proper information, verified information, the next step will be to send our data to Wikidata, say this significant event, which is affected by this earthquake. But we don't know it is how much affected yet. So maybe it is fully damaged, maybe it is half damaged, or etc. So the next step will be to get more information to say it is completely damaged and there is no building anymore because they destroyed and then there is a new building, they are rebuilding the new building, etc. So I think it's a big and time consuming thing because it is 11 cities, I don't know how many cultural heritage items we have. But we had a nice experience with this small rapid fund that we made a trial with the Wikimedia Turkey. How are we going to train people and to get much active user for cultural heritage for Turkey? And I think like my friend said, it is not easy to do it one day. I think we were discussing yesterday, and then you gave a training one day and then people go and then they will not become an active user. So you have to keep their awareness all the time and then give trainings, educations, and then make them active users for the cultural heritage. Now also we were discussing that maybe there will be opportunities for us to educate more young people and then the young people can educate other young people in the universities because we have university clubs, we keep university clubs in Turkey and then there are the information and the course management students created clubs also for information exchange. So maybe our role should be to provide more trainings to the young people, so the young people can give more trainings to other young people, and so we should only provide expertise in terms of cultural heritage. But if you have other suggestions, other easy ways, we are happy to hear and apply, because like we were hearing yesterday from Michael talks, the cultural inventory project in Turkey also, they are doing citizen science webpage. Now they are feeding Wikidata. So if we feed all our structured data to Wikidata, and then say this affected by this significant event, and then this is damaged, and then there is no building, maybe the next step will gather old historical photographs and add them into the commons and then make a view for this area. So how will it be? Because my child will not see the same region again. So it will be a reconstruction of the digital world. So basically, I think it was a small step for us to try these activities and educational things in Turkey for the cultural heritage. But there will be no more steps to take and move forward, I guess. Thank you very much for listening to us. We met with lots of NGOs, the Museum Professional Association. So they are very happy to provide data and the feed this, but they have concerns about the copyrights and then who was doing, I mean, how are we going to provide data because we have our archives, what should I do, etc. So we had several discussions about these copyrights. And then the next step, also we are working with the Wikimedia Turkey and the Creative Commons Turkey communities. So maybe next step to discuss this as an open culture, think about open culture and open data, because we created a Flickr account, so if you don't want to feed your data to Wikicommons directly, so can you put it in Flickr, what is your concerns, etc. I think we should also discuss this and organize several events that to hear people's concerns, and after that probably they will start using this Wikidata and Wikicommons or Wikipedia things. I think it is very, I don't know, maybe in Turkey, or it is very time consuming thing and people are not very willing to give their data and support this data to the data.
Yeah,